So Dante, game week, what's your excitement level as the game creeps closer and closer?
You know, inside I'm very up, but at the same time, you know, I'm also at a level where I can control it and not be too, you know, overwhelmed or too excited to play, because I don't want to be too excited and too overwhelmed right now since it's 3 days away. So I gotta kind of like sort it out until, you know, 7 o'clock on Thursday.
Yeah. As a leader, something has played a lot here. Do you feel a responsibility to kind of make sure your younger teammates are still kind of? And that's going to be a very emotional game Thursday. Yeah. Kind of keep everyone within reason, I guess.
Yeah. Especially, you know, in practice or. If someone gets down on themselves or like just messes up on a play or something like that, I try to, you know, tell them to calm down. We have, I don't want to say plenty of time, but we got enough time for you to fix it and be able to just do the right thing. So, and really, I just try to tell them just to, you know, relax during this whole process, because like this whole build up for this game is kind of. It could be overwhelming for them, especially young guys going to be playing a lot of snaps. So I try to just tell them just relax and just do your best. So.
Last year you opened the road with a rival and it didn't go too well. How do you avoid that this year, repeating that?
It's really just start out fast. Don't really, you know, take punches first. You got to make sure you are playing at the top of your game from snap one to the end. So, and not be, you know, out there, not tired, but just lackadaisical. Is that what you can say? So I don't want to be too amped up. Just go out there and just play hard and it focus on my job. Yeah.
They have a noted offensive line, very veteran. When you watch them on film, what do you see? What are the challenges for you guys?
They're definitely a good group. You know, a veteran group that, you know, I respect them a lot. You know, but at the same time, you know, I can't think about that. Like, I'm not worried about, you know, how many years, because this is my fifth year also. So I'm not going to go out there thinking, oh, they're so much older, but we're all the same age. So I'm going to go out there and just play my hardest. And really, I mean, like, they're a good group. They work, like, they're good together. They're very, like, they understand, you know, how to block, you know, certain things. So, you know, especially with a veteran O-line, you know, that I've seen in the past that, I think the last one was like K-State or something like that. That they're very veteran, so they work good together. They communicate very well, and you know, they're big. So, you know, just gotta go out there and just play hard and do whatever I gotta do to make plays and help this team win.
When you make a big play, what does it do for you, and what does it do for the team? I mean,
For me, it gives me loose, really. Like, you know. After that first play that you make, it kind of gets you, you know, like loosened up and just ready to, you know, it gets you excited. And I feel like, you know, what I try to do when, you know, after I make a play, it's try to get everybody else excited. You know, I want, you know, everybody to get amped up for that, you know, that they may have another opportunity to make a play just like I did. But, you know, I'm not going in here trying to, you know, think I got to make this many plays or, you know, I got to get this stat line this game. I was worried about just going out there and doing my job and play hard as I can from the first play to the end. So, you know, I mean, of course, you know, if I just do my job, the plays will come and stuff like that. But at the same time, you know, I'm just going to go out there and just focus on my keys. Sure.
Is it a focus this week to get Slovis moving a little bit, not keep him in the pocket, to get him out? I'm sure you wouldn't want to do that with Kenny Pickett, but with Slovis, is that kind of the objective?
Yeah, I mean, that's kind of – it's kind of the objective, regardless, you know, of the QB, because, you know, I feel like in the Big 12. I mean, I feel like in the Big 12 is very, you know, the QBs are very dual. They run sideline. They fall out of pocket. So, and this game is really just to really just try to make sure he doesn't get out. But at the same time, if he does, like, we gotta pursue the ball and make tackles. So.
Is life for you, or maybe how much different do you anticipate it will be, kind of given the physical change for the nose position this year? We're bigger, heavier, stronger.
I feel like JJ's doing a great job. He's probably the strongest guy on our team. like from squat to bench, all that. So I feel like he's doing a great job holding it down in there. I feel like from a snap one, like he can make a big impact in the run game and also in the pass game. I feel like he improved his pass rush very well, just, you know, over the last, you know, 8 months. So, and his overall thought process, because, you know, when he first got here, his first four games was, I think he was 17, so he was very young, and he still is young. I think he's 20 still, so, you know, he's still in that, you know, mind, but at the same time, he's very, like, he understands what he has to do to affect the game, so. Yeah.
You got to put two on him, I'm guessing, too.
Yeah, I feel like, you know, regardless, I feel like I'll get double, he get double. I feel like it can happen. I can get double on some plays, but, you know, I feel like it definitely helps if, you know, if I'm doubled or he's doubled, that it can free up a lot of guys to come in and shoot gaps. So.
How's Lockhart doing? I know AJ's called him the dancing bear. How's he? You got 200, 300 and what, 10-plus pound noses.
Yeah.
How is that working out with your defense?
I feel like he's definitely improved his overall conditioning, because, like, I don't think he played spring ball. I think he was in the portal or something like that. I don't really know too much, but at the same time, I feel like he's just grown a lot. You know, he knows the plays a lot. He's run to the ball way better. And he's a big strong guy that can go in there and just and just cause havoc. Because, like, he's played against teams that ran the ball a lot, especially last year. He played Pitt at Georgia Tech, so, like, he understands what they have and what can't and can't happen.
Did he talk to you a little bit about what they do?
Yeah.
And how does the size it knows make your defense different, if at all?
You know, I feel like the bigger the D lineman, the more people has to block him. Okay. You know, doubles, triples, you know, and stuff like that to free up other guys.
Has everybody in Fairmont called you for tickets, and do you just point them to your mom and say, deal with her?
Nah.
How does this work?
It's been very hard, because, like, it's sold out. It's sold out very quick, and, you know, and I only get a certain amount of tickets. So, you know, I want a lot of people to go, but at the same time, I can't take everybody. So, you know, I put in a couple of tickets so far, you know, that I know people are going to go, that my family. But, I mean, I'm still trying to, you know, get tickets. I mean, I'm not really pushing it, because at the same time, you know, I have like a couple more people that I really want to come. I mean, I want all the people that ask me. But at the same time, you know, I just can't do it, and it's just hard, because it's just sold out, like, real quick. So,
is there a desire from the defense amongst the guys to maybe kind of have a do-over from the Guarantee Rate Bowl, the way Minnesota ran the ball against you guys? Yeah. That's something you guys have talked about, because I'm sure Pitt probably looked at that tape and said, hey, this is a place they were vulnerable last year.
Yeah. We definitely knew going into this game that Pitt had access to that film. They had access to all of our last year film. So, like, they understand that, like, from back then how to attack us. But I feel like this year there's a whole different team or a whole different mindset just going into the season. And it literally started from right after the bowl game to our first week to our workouts. So I feel like there's a chip on our shoulders has gotten bigger, and you know, I feel like it won't, like, happen like it did. Cause I feel like, especially the Minnesota game, if you would stop the run, we probably have a good chance to really win that game if we just stop the run. And I feel like this game too, if we stop the run, we have a good chance of winning.
Yeah, anticipation is there that you're going to be challenging the run game.
Yeah, and, you know, my set going this game, I'm ready for that. So, yeah, I'm ready for a run, pass, anything that they throw at us. Yeah.
How exciting is this for you personally, considering, you know, that COVID year happens, you don't even get a chance to play in this game, but now you get to experience the rivalry at least once.
Yeah, it's definitely, you know, I'm definitely, I don't say, like, I can't even put in words, because inside of me is, like, I really just want to be like, I'm so excited, you know, as a kid, but, you know, I can't do that. You know, I am excited. This is definitely a game that, you know, I've always wanted to play in. It's been 11 years, 3 days away now, so it's getting closer and closer. I just got to keep, you know, a level head and just stay relaxed for now, and I don't want to get too amped up. But at 7:30, you know, you'll see.
How do you balance balance that type of emotion? Because obviously you want to play with the emotions, but not to the point where you get too emotional and make some mistakes.
It's really just take it. I try to just take it day by day. I don't want to think about too much to Thursday, even though it's right here. I try to, like, today we have practice today, so today I'm just going to focus on what I need to improve on. And really just, I feel like just my overall maturity, because in the past I'd get so amped up that it wouldn't be funny. But now I'm more relaxed and stuff like that, because I know what I got to do. I'm not going to go in there and try to do too much and not play my game. So.
All that said, what is the first play of a new year like?
I guess you can see. I don't want to tell you guys, because, like, I'd rather just show you. Because I've been waiting for, like I said, I've been waiting for this moment my whole life to play pit, and, you know, since the end of last year to come back, this is all I've been waiting for. So, yeah, I'm excited.
Dante, how's the offense different or better based on your
play? I feel like they definitely got a lot better. A very explosive offense. I feel like our O-line will be one of the best in the Big 12. I'm saying that now. Literally seeing them work from, the end of the bowl game to now has been unbelievable. I feel like they push themselves to a higher standard. I feel like they just push each other every day. I mean, Zach took complete control of the offensive line when they work out, stuff like that. And I feel like they're really close together. So I feel like it's going to be a fun year for them.
Does your dad still break down your, like, practice film for you, call you, give you hints and tips and stuff?
Not as much, because I kind of learned that on my own, to really, you know, sit down and watch film and understand what, you know, technique and scheme that I'm going against, stuff like that. But, you know, I made a couple calls. You know, he's told me what this game is and how big it is and stuff like that. But it's like, you can only say so much. Like, I won't really get the full effect until kickoff. Appreciate you guys.